Hello everybody, good morning. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Electronic Control Unit. In today's presentation, we will be looking into CAN Network Management Part 2. Already I have explained CAN Network Management Part 1 in one other presentation. Those who haven't watched that, please do watch that and then watch this presentation. And in today's presentation, I will be covering below topics, overview, what are all the network states present in CAN-NM, how a state machine is handled in CAN-NM, initialization of CAN-NM module, what are all the configurable parameters, important configuration parameters in CAN network management module, terms to be known while working in CAN-NM module, header file dependency with other modules, how a CAN-NM frame is transmitted and how a CAN-NM frame is received. Let me first explain the overview. This I already explained in detail in part 1 presentation. Just to have a simple overview, CAN-NM is nothing but a module which is present in the service layer of AUTOSAR, and this module is responsible for synchronizing all the nodes in a cluster, and this is also responsible for initial wake up and shutdown of a CAN bus in any ECU. Network states, we have two states, we call it as requested state and released state. Requested state means that in the requested state, network management frames will be transmitted, and this is achieved by a function called CAN-NM network request. And released state, where NM frames will be stopped to transmit, NM frame transmission will be stopped, and in the released state, it will come out of the network mode. And this release state is achieved by a function called CAN-NM network release. State machine detailed overview. As we know already, we have three modes: bus leave mode, prepare bus leave mode, and normal mode. In normal mode, we have repeat message state, normal operation state, and ready sleep state. In it, when the CAN-NM module gets initialized, we will be in bus leave mode, and API to shift from bus leap mode to normal mode is two APIs are there. We call it as CAN-NM passive startup and CAN-NM network request. This passive startup is nothing but this API will be called in passive nodes. What do you mean by passive nodes is, consider you have a ECU where your ECU is okay to only receive the NM frames. Then we configure that ECU as a passive node ECU. In those nodes, we use a function called CAN-NM passive startup to shift from bus leap mode to network mode. Then, once it enters into request mode, the first state is a repeat message state. Whenever it enters into repeat message state, there is something called NM timeout timer. That timer will be started, after which repeat message timer will be started, and also CAN-NM module will inform NM module that it has entered into network mode by API call NM underscore network mode. And in the repeat message state, there is something called bus load reduction mechanism, and this bus load reduction mechanism will be stopped in the repeat message state. And you have NM timeout timer. This timer will be running in parallel. Once it gets expired, again the timer will be restarted in the repeat message state. And also we have something called TX transmit timer, and this timer, once it gets elapsed, there is something called NM NM underscore TX timeout exception API. This API will be called. Consider the repeat message timer got elapsed, then we will move into normal operation state. In the normal operation state, bus load reduction mechanism will be enabled. And consider NM frames got stopped. In that case, CAN-NM network release API will be called, and state will be changed from normal operation state to ready sleep state. In the ready sleep state, NM timeout timer will be running, and if the timeout timer gets expired, state will be moved from ready sleep to prepare bus sleep state. While entering into the prepare bus sleep state, we have something called bus sleep timer. That particular timer will be started, and CAN-NM will inform NM module that it has entered into prepare bus sleep mode by calling NM underscore prepare bus sleep mode API. And from prepare bus sleep to bus sleep mode, you have a timer called bus sleep timer. Once this particular timer got expired, state will be changed from prepare bus sleep mode to bus sleep mode. And this CAN NM will inform NM that it has entered bus sleep mode by calling NM underscore bus sleep mode API. And in between, you have something called CAN NM RX indication. This API will be called whenever a NM frame is received. So parallelly, CAN NM RX indication API will be called to inform that inform CAN NM that there is a reception of NM frame. And here, consider we are in prepare bus sleep state. When there is a CAN NM RX indication function API called, then it will move it to network mode. Or when the API CAN NM passive startup is called, it will move from prepare bus sleep to network mode. Or CAN NM network request for API, if it is called also, it will move from prepare bus sleep to network mode. And consider you are in normal operation state and you receive a NM frame with repeat message bit as set from other nodes, then there will be a transition from normal operation to repeat message state. Similarly, when you are in ready sleep also, if you receive a NM frame with repeat message bit set, then there will be a transition from ready sleep to repeat message state. And if you are in ready sleep state and if a CAN NM network will request NM CAN NM underscore network request API is called, then it will move from ready sleep to normal operation state. So this is a state machine which is present in CAN NM. Initialization. This CAN NM module must be initialized after CAN IF is initialized. CAN IF module is initialized and before any other API which is present in CAN NM is called. During initialization, the network state will be in released state. That is, when initialization by default, the CAN NM module shall set the network state to released state. And also, in the init phase, CAN NM module shall enter into the bus sleep mode initially. That is, by default, CAN NM will be in the bus sleep mode. And while initialization, the user data is initialized with value 0xFF and control bit vector will be initialized with value 0x00. And these are the important timing parameter which is configured in CAN NM. The first timing parameter is CAN NM timeout time. We call it as NM timeout time. And as we saw in the state machine, this NM timeout time is a timer. Once it gets elapsed, there will be a transition from ready sleep to prepare bus sleep. So this NM timeout timer plays an important role in state transition activity. And also, this NM timeout timer will be restarted whenever there is a NM frame reception or a NM frame transmission. And next comes CAN NM repeat message time. This is also a caught variable parameter. And this timer is a time, or during this time, the ECU will be in the repeat message state. Then we have CAN NM wait for bus sleep state. This is the time where the ECU will be in the prepare bus sleep state. And you have something called CAN NM remote sleep indication time. And if no NM frame is received for this time, CAN NM remote sleep indication time, then the state will be transmitted to ready sleep. This timer is actually used globally. So across all the nodes, this timer value will be same. And this timer is used to indicate all the nodes that all other nodes in the cluster has gone to ready sleep. Then we have CAN NM message cycle time. This is a periodic NM message cycle time value. Then you have CAN NM message timeout time. This is nothing but TX timeout time, we call it as. And this parameter is valid only when partial networking is enabled. If TX confirmation is not received, whenever the TX CAN NM frame is transmitted, there will be a confirmation from the lower layer for a by a callback function. We call it as canNM_TX confirmation. And if this canNM_TX confirmation function is not called, then is not called within this particular timer, one after the NM frame is triggered from canNM, canNM will call the exception function called NM_TX timeout time exception. That is, your frame is transmitted, NM frame is transmitted from the canNM module. This NM timeout message timer will be started, and before this timer gets elapsed, if TX confirmation is not received, then NM_TX timeout exception API will be called. Then we have canNM message reduced time. This is nothing but this is the time which is used in bus load reduction mechanism. This timer will serve the same purpose as NM message cycle time when bus load reduction mechanism is enabled. Detail of this bus load reduction you can see in part 1 presentation. And terms to be known, we have something called canNM repeat message request. This is nothing but a API, and this, when this API is called in the NM frame, 0th bit will indicate a repeat message bit. So if this API is called, that repeat message bit will be set. Then we have remote sleep indication. Remote sleep indication denotes situation where a node is in normal operation and all other nodes in a cluster has gone to sleep state. If all other nodes are ready to sleep, then canNM will inform NM module by calling NM_remote sleep indication API. After this, after a timer, we call it as remote sleep timer, which we explained here, remote sleep indication time. So remote sleep indication time is the time required for canNM module to inform NM module that all other nodes in the cluster has entered into sleep state, ready sleep state. Then we have canNM RX indication. This is nothing but a callback function, and if this function is called, the received NM frames, means what's that, canNM module shall copy the data of the received NM PDU into an internal buffer, and also NM timeout timer will be restarted whenever this canNM RX indication is called. Then we have canNM TX confirmation. This is also a callback function, and this API will say whether the NM frame is transmitted successfully or not. Then we have canNM immediate restart enabled, and if this is nothing but a configurable tag in the config downsy configurator. So if this particular tag is enabled, then whenever you are in prepare bus sleep state, NM frame is received, immediately NM frame will be transmitted for your ECU. Then we have canNM no detection enabled. This is also a tag, just a tick which we do it in a downsy configurator. And if this is enabled, our ECU will detect what are all the nodes in the cluster which is active. That is, detection of present nodes, which are all the nodes present, by reading the node ID of the received NM frame. In the NM frame, we'll have something called source node ID. And if this is enabled only, that source node ID will be read by our ECU. Then we have canNM node ID enabled. Only if this is enabled, our source node will be transmitted in the NM frame. Then we have bus load reduction mechanism. Only if this is enabled, bus load reduction will be mechanism will be enabled. Then we have NM passive mode. As already explained, a passive ECU is nothing but an ECU which will only receive the NM frame. So if your ECU wanted to be a passive ECU, then canNM passive mode enabled should be made available, which means canNM passive mode, that particular tag should be enabled. Then you have canNM PDU RX indication enabled. Only if this is enabled, CAN NM will call the NM PDO-RX indication whenever CAN NM RX indication is called. That is, whenever CAN NM RX indication is called, only when this particular tag is enabled, CAN NM will inform NM module that there is a reception of the NM frame by calling a callback function NM underscore PDO-RX indication. Header file dependency. As you can see, this is our module cannm.c file, and here we have dependency to these many header files. We have a configuration, an NM stack, com stack, canif.h file, and pdorcannm.h file. To these many header files, this cannm.c file has a dependency. Now let's see how a CAN frame is transmitted. It means a CAN NM frame is transmitted. Consider you have a message cycle time. Say the value of this timer is 10 seconds or 2 seconds. So after this 2 seconds gets expired, CAN NM will call CAN IF transmit. So once a CAN IF transmit give a positive feedback, then CAN NM will start again the timer, message cycle timer will again be started. And also you have something called message timeout timer, TX timeout timer, that will also be started. After which CAN IF will indicate CAN NM that transmission is successful or not by calling CAN NM TX confirmation. If it is EOK, yeah, CAN NM will understand that transmission is successful, and it will stop the message timeout time. Let's see how the CAN NM frame is received. Whenever a CAN NM frame is received in the bus, CAN IF will inform CAN NM by calling CAN NM RX indication API. This, as we saw, CAN NM RX indication API has the data of the received NM frame. Once this is called, CAN NM will copy the data to a received CAN NM data to a internal buffer. So consider bus load reduction mechanism is enabled. In that case alone, once whenever CAN NM RX indication is called, this message timeout timer will be restarted, and also message cycle time will be reloaded with CAN NM message reduced time. This is the time which is used for transmission of NM frame, as you know already from our ECU. And after which, after the received data is properly copied to an internal buffer, a feedback is given to CAN IF via this CAN IF, via the return value of the CAN NM RX indication. That's all in today's presentation. Hope you understood CAN NM module to some extent. Kindly give me feedback whether you understood properly, and also any other suggestion is also welcome. Thank you so much for your time. All the best.